people learn biodigester construction for only 2 days and they want to construct a biodigester in a waterlogged area. Some even attempt replacing manholes or septic tanks with biodigesters, and some go as much as constructing a biodigester for public toilets. That's very, very wrong. Are you interested in learning how to construct a biodigester? Then watch this video till the end. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. If you are new to this channel, subscribe for videos that explains how these amazing biodegradable waste biodigesters are helping homeowners have a new lease of life in terms of their toilet wastewater management issue. We are on Instagram at Dreamhouse Biodigesters. I know of people who learn how to install biodigester. They go for biodigester training for only 2 days, and the next day you see them, they are installing a biodigester in a public toilet, or they are changing people's manholes into biodigesters, or they are even constructing biodigesters in a waterlogged area. And anybody who is learning a biodigester installation must follow the first and simple rule. You cannot walk until you learn to crawl. If you are a new car buyer, the advice is always to go for an old car, get used to the road, learn how to drive on bumpy roads, learn how to maneuver yourself in the potholes, learn how to drive in the raining, how to drive on those slippery roads, and of course learn how to drive in congested and traffic areas, so that when you are firm in handling the steer in the car wheel, then you can go and buy the one, your desired car, and then you're not going to have a problem. If you buy a new car and you're a first time driver, I'm sure you have an experience of having the car scratch or the car damage or accident happening to you. The same thing with biodigesters. You want to be the best at your job, learn the basics. Just don't wake up and start constructing biodigesters for places that you know are going to give you problem. When we started this job, what we did was to do the digesters for low income houses. Low income houses means that there's a compound house and then you are doing the digester for a superstructure. So the superstructure is outside the house and then you are doing the digester at the back of the superstructure. You are using a KVIP seat or you are using a P-trap seat, which gives you enough elevation and the footing is there, and then the digester is done at the back of it. The footing is up and you are using a P-trap or the KVIP seat, right? So what it means is the digester will not go down. You are not going to dig more than 1 or 2 feet to install a biodigester. This also has got an effect on your soakaway. It also means that your soakaway is not going to go deep, because if you are doing 2 feet maximum on a digester, you can do 3 feet on the soakaway, or that's the soakaway pit, and then the water will always have a way to go. I mean, the digester is projected up and there's always space in your digester for you to work. There will never be a problem of you saying that the digester is full and that there's a problem there. If you want to learn biodigester construction, it's never going to happen in a day. I've done videos that explains how these biodigesters work and the best way you have to install a biodigester. If you are installing a biodigester in a waterlogged area, what you should look out for. If it's in a sandy area, what you should also look out for. And if it's a clay area, the conditions and what you should always look out for. The basics for somebody who is learning biodigester installation is your gradient, is your slope, is the inside filtration system, is the pipe that is coming into the digester, which is key, and then the outlet going into the soakaway. When you have all these things done well, then you are good to go. I do know of people, plumbers and masons, who have seen biodigester being constructed at a site, and then the next day, they are also doing some for homeowners. I've always advised homeowners, if you want the best, you have to pay for the best and you have to do your homework and know that the constructor you are getting is somebody you can trust and somebody who can do a good job. If you're a plumber, the advice is always to stick to what's good for you or what you are good at and then build your brand from there. But those who want to learn how to construct a biodigester, my advice is simple. Go ahead and learn it well. Each house has got its own peculiar situation. You can never, one size does not fit all when it comes to biodigester construction. And you can never learn one thing and replicate it. Most of us who started this industry 6 years ago had a lot of problems. We did biodigesters for people that there were problems. We had to go back and go back and go back again. And the money that they paid for was virtually used up. And we had to use our own money just to do the correction. So becoming a biodigester installer takes time. Doesn't mean that you cannot learn it. You learn it, but then the more you do it, the more you become good at it. And the key part here is that if you do a good job, you get testimonials that you can use in other works. Then you can go for estate houses, you can go for public toilets, or you can then go for domestic users or high income earners who are willing to pay a higher fee for a good job. Then when you are designing your digester, you know the design and the fit and everything will just work well. And when you have a client who wants to see your work, then you will be confident in sending them your own pictures instead of going on the net to look for pictures that are not really your work and you are giving them to clients. That's not a good start when you want to build client-customer relationship for your business. You are looking at the long term, you are looking at doing a business that will serve you well and will serve you and your family in the long term. Then building key trust or building key relationship is important for you. Watching the next two videos will show you how these biodigesters work and how they are helping homeowners have a new lease of life.